take your body and turn it into little pieces. I'll have the evidence and act like everything's fine. I'll take your body and turn it into little pieces. I'll have the evidence and act like everything's fine.
Happy Friday the 13th, everyone, and welcome back to Nimrod Horror Review. I'm back in like the studio, and I'm kind of working on like a slightly different background, so it's kind of spotty right now. And since it's Friday the 13th, it's going to be September, which is the 9th month, so I decided to just review the 9th Friday film, which is Jason Goes to Hell. So the basic story to this film is just like the SWAT team comes to a Crystal Lake, and they trap Jason into meeting him in this big field where like Jason's chasing after this girl, and he's caught. These bright lights start shining on him, and just a bunch of gunfire. You know, tons of SWAT team members are just shooting him constantly, and then finally, Jason just explodes, and his body parts are all over the place. But then we see Jason's heart still beating. So when the coronaries examining Jason's body, he decides to eat Jason's heart. It's this weird demonic force that like makes him eat his heart, and that seems a little bit gross, but you know, it's intended to be a little bit gross. So then now he becomes Jason, and after a certain while, the bodies that Jason inhabits start decomposing, and he has to find like a new body. So that's a good portion of the film is like Jason's, I guess, soul jumps from body to body. The only way Jason can actually resurrect to like the real Jason Voorhees is through another family member. And so like Jason's trying to track down some of his family members. And then there's this bounty hunter. His name's Duke, he basically knows how to finally kill Jason. Basically, a Voorhees family member has to kill him with this, you know, affirme, and then send Jason straight to hell. So that's basically the whole storyline. The only difference was this one was supposed to be the final, the end-all. So we thought, but the real reason this film was also made was because New Line just picked up the Friday franchise, and they wanted to, you know, have Freddy versus Jason. This was an idea that like happened like I think back in like 1988. It just took Paramount and a New Line to work out something, and eventually with like the Jason film slowly declining in a business, they sold New Line the rights to Jason Voorhees. The problem with this film, this is maybe the worst Friday / Jason film ever. New Line did a really bad job at this character and this story. There's so many bad things about this film. One thing is the music is horrendous. It's like horrible music. It sounds like a really cheap Casio that you find at Toys R Us. We'll be right back. it's really bad. The only good music parts are, like, whenever they incorporate the original movies, like, soundtracks into it. But overall, it's terrible sound, it's terrible music. The acting's overall really bad. Jason looks horrible. This is, like, the worst-looking Jason ever. Because it's, like, his mask is, like, squished into his face, and it looks like a really fat guy. It's Jason does not look good. The makeup design was horrible for Jason on this film. The storyline's pretty lame. And the whole way that Jason's finally killed, or how you can actually kill him, made no sense. It's like, how does that make any sense with, like, the previous 8 films? It's just stupid. The director, Adam Marcus, just does a terrible job. The film looks bad, and there's, like, this kind of, like a Terminator 2 vibe sometimes you get from it. Like they were trying to mimic Terminator 2. This is probably the film that I've seen the most times, and I consider it a bad film. Like, I've seen it several times just because since this is a Jason film, but Jason's actually only in it for, like, maybe 3 minutes, you know. And the kills are so-so in this film. They're not, like, fantastic kills. I mean, there's very little good things to say. The best thing, which I'm pretty sure most people have seen this film, is the last, like, 30 seconds when Freddy Krueger's hand comes up and takes Jason's mask. That's pretty cool, and that definitely gets you hyped to see Freddy versus Jason. Which also is kind of like, well, then they... That's saying that they weren't actually killing off Jason for sure, since they were already planning this Freddy vs. Jason movie. Anyway, but yeah, this film's pretty bad. But I would only suggest watch this film if you are, like, a hardcore Jason fan. If you just like 1 or 2 Friday films, don't watch this one. If you thought part 7 and part 8 were bad, this one's pretty bad. This one's worse. I'm one of the few people who may say that they like Jason X a little bit better than this film. It's pretty bad. Saying that, I'm just going to wrap it up here. And I'm going to give this... A pretty poor, it should be lower, but I'm going to give this a 4 out of 10 hockey mask. See you guys later.
No, get away from me, you fucking piece of fuck, small piece!